Today, we will present from our company through this presentation, which have four sections. Let us start with the company overview. Ms. Gulabi will explain all details for our company overview.
Okay, let's start with the company overview. Gangun was founded in the year 1982 as an electrical equipment trader. Then we expanded ourselves into the manufacturing business. We manufacture and supply of over 5,000 electrical parts. And our next business is the construction business. We have constructed for the power plant of the solar farm, wind farm, and solar rooftop for almost 400 megawatts already. And our last business is our power plant operator. We have the power purchase agreement on hand for almost 550 megawatts in Thailand, Myanmar, Japan, and also Malaysia. As of the fourth quarter, we have 315 megawatts on hand in operations. And the next page here is our milestone since the founding year in 1982. And 10 years later, we have set up our own manufacturing factory. And the highlight year is in the year 2010 that we are supplying and set up Thailand's first wind turbine for EGAT. That was the trigger point that we enter into the renewable energy business as an construction and operation and maintenance contractor. In the same year, we got the first power purchase agreement for 31 megawatts named Gangun Chubut Power Gen for solar farm. In the same year also, we are listed in the stock exchange of Thailand. And it's so interesting that the year later, we are listed in the Set 100. Year from year, we got the more power purchase agreement and do more power plant year from year. Until now, as I said earlier, we have the power purchase agreement on hand for 550 megawatts. And now we target to achieve 1,000 contracted equity megawatt by the year 2020. In the below part of this page, we show the EBITDA as the pie chart show the portion between our conventional business of the trading and EPC in the light blue and the renewable power generation in the navy blue. It is obviously shown that since last year, in the year 2017, our EBITDA has transformed. We transformed ourselves from the conventional business, which has volatile earnings and lower margin, to a renewable energy player that has stable cash flow and high margins. And this page shows our portfolio in Thailand and international. In Thailand, we have solar farm, wind farm, solar rooftop, and also private PPA. And in Myanmar, we have gas fire plant for 25 megawatts that we hold a portion of 50%. And in Japan, we have solar farm for 4 sites that already COD, the COD in the 1st of November, named Sendai. The capacity megawatts is 31 megawatts. And our new investment is in Malaysia that our total megawatt for solar farm is 30 megawatts and we have the economic benefit for 70% that the equity megawatts of our country is 21 megawatts. Here is our four missions to achieve the vision to become an Asia's leading renewable company. First of all, we plan to expand our construction business from only the power plant into the transmission line and substation sector, which are supported by the Thailand government. In the in the 3rd of July, we have just acquired the construction company named Future Electrical Control. It is very a good advantage for our Gangun because this company has the very good experience and very good profile in transmission line and substation construction. The next one, as I said earlier, by the year 2020, we step to secure 1,000 megawatts by increasing capacity through domestically and internationally. This is include in Thailand, Japan, which we has already has an experience and keen in this business, and also in Malaysia and Vietnam. And the third one, we enhance the company growth by entering into a private producer segment. that and the fourth one, we embrace the new technology to drive growth and expose our new opportunity in the next step. During this year in the in May, during May, we have just launched our new product named Groove, which come from Kangkun Rooftop, which we target to our new potential customer, which is a household. I believe that this is a very good good path for our potential client in the next step further.
Okay, next section for the financial highlight. go to page 9. I would like to show that our financial position. If you see the bar chart on page 9, compared to the end of the year 2017, at the end of the 2017, Kangkun Engineering has the asset about 30 billion, but by the 9-month performance or in this year, the increasing of the balance sheet about 16 to 17%, our asset is about 34.6 billion at the end of September this year. And also next page, for the revenue breakdown and earnings, if you compare the 9-month performance 2017 and 2018 on the right hand side, it will show that by this year, the 9-month performance, our top line or our revenues is increasing to 4.7 billion baht. And also compared to the whole year 2017, it's about 4.8 in 2017. So that means this 9-month revenue is, we can say that is equal the whole year of 2017. But if you focus on the net profit, our net profit margin, so in the financial statement, the net profit margin will show about 17 to 18%. But if you focus on our normal operation, the net profit margin is about 30%. So it increasing up from 16 to 17% last year. That's why this 9-month performance show that it's beat the whole years of the 2017 already. Okay, next, this is the forecasting revenue and our EBITDA. By 2018, we plan that our revenue can be over 6 billion baht. And also the EBITDA, we show that about 3.3 approximately, and also increasing in 2019 to 7.5 billion for the revenue and the EBITDA over 4 billion for the EBITDA. This is increasing significantly in the next few years for the Kangkun Engineering by the COD all project. Okay, next, the section 3, it's a investment highlight. This section, I will show you about why renewable sector and why Kangkun. The first reason that there still be solid growth potential and for the renewable energy in Thailand. If you see the electricity consumption chart on the upper left hand side, the electricity consumption will continue to outstrip generation. So that's why there's to be an opportunity for the renewable players in the next 10 years. And also if you compare to the renewable energy capacities from 2017 to 2036 by the PDP plan of Thailand, in the 2017, the capacity is just 5.5 gigawatt, but to 2036, the plan that show that the renewable should go up to 16.3 gigawatt. If you're looking for, looking toward 2036, the solar power play a significant part in the growth of the renewable energies at about 4.4 growth per annum. Why the wind power demonstrate that the strong development at about 9% per annum growth. This is the capacity that show that the opportunity still be there in the next 10 years. Next, we believe that the government policy from the foreign still support the fast growth in the renewable sectors. So on this page, we choose the three countries that we focus. The first one is Japan. If you see the Japan's energy plan, that's revised, updated 20, 2015, the Japan planned to promote the use of the renewable energy to account for about 24% in 2030. That means promote the generation from the solar up to 7% and wind to around 2% for the total generating capacities. And for the Malaysia plan, they increased the share of the renewable energy electricity from the 2017. There will be just about 560 megawatt. They plan to up to 3.5 gigawatt, about 13 to 14% by the year 2030s, and also promote the generation from solar from 370 megawatt in 2017 to about 900 megawatt by 2030. This is about three times from now. And also for Vietnam provide the adequate electricity for the growing demand through the construction of the power transmission grid. They inject the budget for the create the infrastructure for the grid and substation, and also prioritize who use the renewable energies from less than 1% in 2016 to more than 10% in 2030. And also, if you see the solar, Vietnam plan to the capacity up to 12 gigawatt, and also wind from 140 to 6,000 megawatt. This is the total generating capacities to the 2030 in Vietnam. So if you see the government policy, they support the opportunities to grow for the renewable players. Okay, next, for our track record of the accelerated growth of the COD project for Cancun. If you see on page 15, from 2011 until now, we have the CAGRs of the equity megawatt, the COD equity megawatt, over 45%. And also, we plan to COD all 542 megawatt that we acquired. The amount of the equity megawatt that we acquire right now to the year 2020s. That means we target to from now about 450 megawatt additional should be achieved by the year 2021. Okay, next, for Cancun, this is our business model that allowed Cancun to exploit the economies of scale and cost saving advantage because of we start with the trading and manufacturing business since 30 years ago. We have over 5,000 items for the manufacturing line, and also we do the contracting. We do the contact the EPC, the solar farm and the wind farm, totally about 400 megawatt so far. And also right now we also are the operators of the power plant, our own power plant, diversification by the geographical into the Myanmar, Thailand, Malaysia, Japan, and also in the neighbor countries in the next few years. Okay, not only the solar and wind. I think for Cancun, we try to capture the untapped potential of rooftop solar and the new technologies. I think for these few years in the future, the private PPA is our opportunities in Thailand. That means we have to focus or choose the clients who can survive in the next 20 to 30 years. And also the model for the private PPA that we build, operate and transfer when they can achieve the unit of buying the electricity unit from ours. This is the one model of the private PPA. And also we do the EPC for the industry or the factory who interesting to use the solar rooftop to benefit of cost saving to their company. This is our Cancun expertise. And next, okay, this page is show that our management to drive the growth of the company that you know that Mr. Cancun in this industry over 40, 50 years ago. And also our CEO, Ms. Silvacha Damlong Piyawut, and our MD, Dr. Somboon Uachasai. This is the key man of the company to drive the growth in the futures. Okay, next, we would like to show you our project update. In this year, start with in this year, we COD two projects of wind. The first one named the Green Innovation Power. The installed capacity about 67.5 megawatt COD since the first quarter of this year at the 27 March. And also the third wind project of us named Kolat Wind Energies, installed capacity about 50 megawatt COD in the second quarter this year, 20 June. This is already COD and now operating. I think the performance is quite good for this year. Next is some details of the Green Innovation Power project that we use the 33 wind turbines generators, capacity 2 and 2.1 megawatts in the Korat area. If you see the picture, this is we developed from the green field. And also we bring the rotor, we bring the tube, the tubula to combine to the turbine, each turbine in the area. If you see that, this is our substation in the Green Innovation Power area. For the Green Innovation Power wind project, we can claim that our turbine is the world's highest tubular wind turbine for the overall height of the 210 meters. This is the highest in Southeast Asia. Okay, so for the Kolat Wind project details, we install or setting up the turbine about 2.5 megawatt, 20 wind turbine generators in this area. For this project, I would like to share that the layout of the turbine is different from the first two projects of us. The layout of the turbine of the Kolat Wind Energy is a direct line. That means that can decrease or the reduce the wake loss very much. So the efficiency for this project is very good. We believe that. As well, this project we developed from the green field. If you see the pictures on the next page. Each turbine we installed by each special clan on the Korat province on the direct line projects. This is the latest two wind projects, total 110 megawatt that just we COD at the first half of this year. So next, for the our overseas project in Japan, named Sendai, Ms. Gulabi will share you the details that how about this project update.
For Sendai, this is our first Japan solar project that has just COD since 1st of November this year. The location is in Sendai, and the contract capacity is 31.8 megawatts, and the install capacity is 38.1 megawatts. We have already COD. This is our perspective at the site in southern area, northern area. And here is the COD ceremony that our chairman, Khun Kan Kun, and the partner, and also the lender bank is in join in this ceremony also. Here's our view of the site. And this is our second project at Japan named Kimitsu. The location is in Kimitsu, Shiba. And the contract capacity is 33.5 megawatts, and the install capacity is 40.4 megawatts. We got our permit already and plan to COD in the first quarter of next year. Here is our project view. It is almost done, 99% already. Next one is solar rooftop and solar floating.
Okay, not only the solar farm. I think Kan Kun, we do the solar rooftop as the picture that we shown. If you see for the big factory, the industrial zone on the our partner with the WHA. If you see the picture, this picture is I can say that the lower picture is this is the rooftop on the WHA factory, and the upper left hand side for the bank of glass, This is our rooftop that Kangkun we do the EPC for the solar rooftop industry. And also not only for the rooftop, we do the solar floating as well for the EGAT. The capacity not much because it's a pilot project. It's about a quarter of megawatt in Kheon Sirinthorn, Ubon Ratchathani province. This is our performance for the next project of the solar floating if the EGAT or the clients need Kangkun to do the EPC that we ready to do because we have the performance to do the floating solar as well. Okay, this is our business and our plan and our direction that we share you the details. There are some questions. I think let's start with the first one. Asking about the dividend policy and the potential to the increased payout. Okay, for the dividend policy of the company is at least 40% of the net profit every year. And if you see the last year, we paid the payout ratio, I think it's over 90% last year. That show that it's increased or it's over the policy. And also, the second question that's asked about, do we have the plan to less one? No. Because I think right now the liquidity is enough and the room for the investment still have the room for the investment because the interest bearing debt is about 2.3, 2.4, so the covenant is about 3. So we have the room is about 0.6, 0.7. So it's enough for the new investment, so no need to raise the fund. The next question, do you expect to initiate new projects related to EPC? Yes, we do, but maybe not really the initiate the new projects, but the related to the EPC, I think is about the maybe in the trading portfolio operation in our financial statement to sell to EPC the project or the product, the new product related the budget of the EEC. I think we can join maybe 10 to 20% market share for this project. The next question, please break down of the margins in each project wind solar. Let me say that for the wind, I think for the wind project, if you see the cost per megawatt is about 80 to 90 million baht per megawatt. The gross margin, I think, is about 50 to 60%. This is for the wind project. But actually, it depends on the seasonal as well in each year. But right now, for about 2 years that we COD the first wind project, it's still be getting along our projection for the wind project. So right now, we can see the gross margin over 50%. And I think the bottom line may be about not less than 40% for the wind project. But for the solar project, it depends on the tariff scheme because we have the first generation of tariff about 8 baht adder, 6.5 adder, and also feed-in tariff 5.66. So these three schemes can generate the difference of the margin of each project. If he's talking about the adder 8 baht, this can generate the equity IRR very good, over 30 to 40%. But for the feed-in tariff 5.66, I think it's about the margin for each megawatt is about, I think, one third from the adder 8 baht. This is the margin of each scheme of the solar system or the solar tariff from the government. Okay, no more questions. So this is our company overview and our performance and also the direction that the Kangkun Engineering would like to direct or drive the company to growth in the future. So if you guys have any questions, you can email to us or you can go to our website and contact our IR in any questions. Thank you very much.
Thank you.